The Diamond Sutra, Whispers of the Unknown. Whispers of the unknown always come as new. You never knew, you never know what the unknown and unknowable wants to communicate to you. You have to be open and utterly vulnerable. However, people never accepted you in the first instance. There is always resistance in accepting you, and in fact, we meet everything new reluctantly, with fear, rather than with joy and willingness. Remember, the new never arises out of you. Instead, it comes from the beyond. It always comes as whispers. It is not part of you. Your whole past is at stake when you are hearing the whispers of the unknown. The new is discontinuous with you, hence the fear arises. You have lived in one way, your entire thinking has been in one way, you have made a comfortable life out of your belief systems. And now something new and unknown knocks on the door. Your whole past pattern is going to be disturbed. If you allow the new, you will never be the same again. The new will transform you, but there is fear, and fear is bound to happen. You cannot imagine anything beyond your cognition. It is risky. One never knows where will you end with the new. The old is known and familiar as well. You have lived with it for long. You are acquainted with it. The new is unfamiliar. It may be a friend. It may be the enemy. Who knows? And there is no way to know. The only way to know is to allow the new, the unknown, to happen. This is the reason there is apprehension and uneasiness, and you cannot remain rejecting it either. The old has not given you yet what you seek. The old has been promising, but the promises have never been fulfilled. The old has been promising, but the promises have never been fulfilled. So what to do? And you are always afraid not to accept the new. Maybe the new is going to be uncomfortable, but there is a possibility. It may bring bliss to you. So you cannot reject it either. And you cannot accept it either. This is the dilemma. This makes you waver. You tremble. Great anguish arises in your being. It is natural. Nothing has gone wrong. This is how it has always been. This is how new will always be. Try to understand the appearance of the new. Everybody in the world wants to become new because nobody is satisfied with the old. Nobody can ever be satisfied with the old, because whatsoever is, you have known already. Once known, it becomes repetitive. Once known, it becomes boring and monotonous. You want to get rid of it. You want to explore. You want to adventure. You want to become new. And yet, when new knocks on the door, you shrink back. You withdraw. You hide in the old and go back to the past habits. This is the dilemma. How do we become transformed then? Only when you embrace the unknown, the new, with trust in existence, the process of transformation begins. Existence does no wrong, and everybody wants to become new. Courage is needed for this. No ordinary courage, instead extraordinary courage is needed. You have to stake all that you have. And the world is full of cowards. This is the reason people have stopped growing. How can you grow if you are a coward? With each new opportunity you shrink back. You close your eyes. How can you grow then? How can you be? You can only pretend to be. And because you cannot grow, you have to find substitute for growth. You cannot grow. You cannot grow inwardly, but your balance can grow. So too your properties can grow, and you can go on boasting for this. This is a poor substitute. It needs no courage. It is perfectly good and adjusted with your cowardliness. Your bank balance goes on growing, and you start thinking that you are growing. In fact, you go on shrinking within. You become more respectable. Your name and fame goes on growing, and you think you are growing inwardly. With your bank balance and properties, you think you are growing. Those who know how to live or what life is prefer to live in the storms of life. Those who know how to live or what life is prefer to live in the storms of life. You are simply deceiving yourself. Your name is not you, so too your fame is not you, your balance is not your being. But if you think of being, you start shaking. Remember, if you want to grow, then you have to drop all cowardice. Shaur is zindagi hatine, tufano milate. Shaur means one who knows the ways and means of life and living. They like to live in storms, like to live amidst storms. Shaur means the way to live life. Life means zindagi. Shaur zindagi hai jadi, those who understand the life and living and its ways and means, they prefer to remain amidst the storms. How do we become new? We do not become new of ourselves. Newness comes from the beyond, and beyond refers to God, the unknown and unknowable. Newness comes from existence. Mind is always old. Mind is never new. Mind is the acquisition of the past. Newness comes from the beyond. It is a gift from God. It is from the beyond, and it is of the beyond. The unknown and unknowable, the beyond, has made ingress into you. It has ingress into you because you are never sealed and set apart. You are not an island. You may have forgotten the beyond. You may have forgotten and yet still pretend that you know and remember every day. But how do you remember? Is asking for this or that is your way of remembering God? The real way of remembering God is your thankfulness for all that you have been showered moment to moment. And remember, the beyond has not forgotten you. The child may have forgotten the mother, but the mother has not forgotten the child. The part may have started thinking itself separate from the whole. However, the whole knows that you are not separate. You are not alien. The whole has imprisoned you. It is still in contact with you. It is in communion with you. That is why the you goes on coming, although you never welcome it. It comes every morning. It comes every evening. It comes in a thousand and one ways. If you have eyes to see, you will see it continuously coming to you, without any obstruction, without anything. It goes on coming to you, but you cannot recognize it. God goes on showering on you bounties in million ways, but you are enclosed into your past. You are almost like a veil. You have become insensitive. Because of your cowardliness, you have lost all sensitivity. To be sensitive means the new will be felt, and the thrills of the new, the passion and the adventure will arise, and you will start moving into the unknown, not knowing where are you going, where will it lead you to. But mind thinks this is mad. Mind thinks this is not rational, to leave the old completely. But God is always new. God means newness, not a person sitting somewhere, not the Abba as Christians call a father image. That is why we cannot use past tense or future tense for God. We cannot say God was, and we cannot say God will be. We can only say God is. It is always fresh and virgin, and it has access in you. Remember, anything new coming in your life is a message from God. If you accept it, you are religious. If you reject it, you are non-religious. Man needs just to relax a little more to accept the new. He has to open a little more to let the new in. Give way to God entering in. This is the meaning of prayer or meditation. Prayer and meditation implies you are open to new. You open up and say yes, and you say, come. Come in. You welcome the new when it knocks at your door to enter your being. You say that I have been waiting and I am thankful that you have come. Always receive the new with great joy. When I say joy, I mean with great joy. Even if sometimes the new leads you into inconvenience, still the new is worth it. Even if sometimes the new leads you into some trouble, still it is worth it. Because only through errors one learns, And only through difficulties one grows. The new will bring difficulties. That is why you choose the old. And old never brings any difficulties. It is a consolation, a shelter. And only you accept the new and deeply and totally, it can transform you. You cannot bring the new into your life. It comes always on its own. You can either accept it or reject it. If you reject, you will remain a stone, closed and lifeless. If you receive it, you will become a flower. Your petals start opening. And in that opening, there is celebration. Only the new can transform. There is no other way to transformation. But remember, it has nothing to do with you and your effort. But to do nothing does not mean cease to act. For new, you have to act without will or direction or impulse from your past. The search for the new is totally different. It cannot be an ordinary search. It is for the new. How can you search for it? You do not know it and you have never met it. The search for the new is going to be just an open exploration. One knows not. One has to start in a state of not knowing and then move innocently like a child, thrilled with every possibility. And remember, there are infinite possibilities. You cannot do anything to create the new. Because whatsoever you do will be of the old, arising from the past. But that does not mean that you have to cease to act. It is to act without will or direction or impulses from your past. Therefore, act without any will or direction or impulse from the past, but act meditatively and spontaneously. Let the moment decide itself. You do not impose your decisions, because the decision will arise from the past and it will destroy the new. You just act in the moment like a child, utterly abandon yourself to the moment, and then you will find every day new openings, new light and new insights for you. And then you will find every day new openings, new light and new insights for you. And those new insights will go on changing you. One day suddenly you will see you are each new moment new. The old no longer lingers or hangs around you like a plant. You are like a dew drop, fresh, young and overflowing. Remember, a Buddha lives moment to moment. Like a majestic wave, one day he appears on life's ocean. With great joy and dance it comes up, with hope and dreams to touch the stars. Then the play begins and lasts for the moment. And then the wave disappears into the vastness of the ocean. It will come again to have another day. Once again it will dance, and then again it will be gone. So it goes. So is God. It comes, disappears, comes again and disappears. So, is a Buddha consciousness or Krishna consciousness? Each moment it comes, acts, responds and is gone. Again it comes and then it is gone. It is atomic. Between two moments there is a gap. In that gap Buddha disappears. I say a word to you and then I disappear in my silence. Then I say another word and I am there. And then again I disappear in my silence. When I dissolve in my silence, I am no more physical. There is a subtle presence, nameless, formless and bodiless. Each time I respond to you and then I am no more. The response is again there and I am no more. Those intervals or those empty spaces keep one utterly fresh, because only death can keep you absolutely alive. Naturally, all these years, you die once after 60 or 70 years. Naturally, all these years you accumulate thoughts, emotions, conditionings as garbage. A Buddha, on the contrary, dies every moment. No garbage is accumulated and nothing is ever persist. That is why Buddha, Subhuti, Buddha tells Subhuti that to possess monks is to be a fraud. Because possession is always of the past, not to possess monks is to be a Buddha. Just think of it. Each moment arising, just like a breath, you breathe in, you breathe out, you breathe in again, you breathe out again. Each breath coming in is life and each breath going out is death. You are born with each incoming breath and then you die with each outgoing breath. Let each moment be a birth and a death. Then you will be new and fresh. But this new has nothing to do with your past, your will, your direction, your impulse. It has to act spontaneously. It is not reaction, instead a response. All that is done out of the past is old, so that one can of oneself do nothing new. To see this is to be done with the old and with the past and with you. That is all we can do. But it is everything, it is all. Upon the ending of the old, the new may follow. It may not. It does not matter. The very wish for the new is an old wish. Is old wish. Then one is utterly open. Even to ask for the new is an old wish. Buddha is not even asking for new. There is no desire for anything that it should be like this or that. If there is desire, you will manage it like that. You will impose yourself upon it. See life desirelessly. See life without any conditions. See life as it is. This is called Yatha Bhutam, as it is. And you will be constantly renewed and rejuvenated. That is the real meaning of resurrection. If you understand this, you will be free from memory. Indeed, you will be free from memory, psychological memory, that is. Memory is a dead thing. Memory is not truth and can never be, because truth is always alive, truth is life. Memory is persistence of that which is known. It is living in a ghost world, but it contains us. It is our prison. In fact, it is us. Memory creates the obstacles, the complex called I, and naturally, this false entity called I is continuously afraid of death. That is why you are afraid of me. And the moment you are vulnerable and open to view, the China wall of ego cannot steal you. Start embracing you as it comes. This I, the ego, is afraid, not really you. The being has no fear, but ego has fear. Because the ego is very afraid of dying, it is artificial, it is arbitrary, it is put together, it can fall apart any moment, and when the new enters, there is no way for it to stay on. There is fear. Ego is afraid, it may fall apart. Somehow it has been managing to keep itself together, to keep itself in one piece, and now something new comes, it will be a shattering thing. That is why you do not accept the new with joy. The ego cannot accept its own death willingly. How can it accept its own death with joy? No, it can never accept. Unless the understanding dawns that you are not the ego, you will not be able to receive the view. Once you have seen that ego is your past memory and nothing else, that you are not your memory, that memory is just like a biocomputer, it is a machine, a mechanism, utilitarian, but you are beyond it. You are consciousness, not memory. Memory is the content in consciousness. However, you are consciousness itself. For example, you see somebody walking on the road. You remember the face, but you cannot remember the name. If you are the memory, you should remember the name too. But you say, I recognize the face, but I do not remember the name. This is natural. So you have nothing to think about. Then you start looking into your memory. You go inside your memory, you look to this or to that side, and suddenly the name bubbles up and you say, yes, this is his name. Memory is your record, and you are the one who is looking into the record, so you are not the memory itself. And it happens many a times that if you become tense in trying to remember a name or something else, it becomes difficult to remember, because the very tension does not allow the memory to release the relevant information to you. You try again and again to remember the name and it does not surface, and you say it is just on the tip of the tongue. You know that you know, but still the name is not coming up. Now this is strange. If you are memory, then who is preventing you, and why is it not surfacing? And who is this saying, I know, but still it is not coming to the surface? And then you try harder and the more difficult it becomes. Then, fed up with the whole thing, you go into the garden for a walk, and suddenly, looking at the rose bush, it is there, it has surfaced. Your memory is not you, you are consciousness. Memory is content, but memory is the whole life energy of ego. Remember, memory is the whole life energy of ego. Memory is, of course, old and it is afraid of new. Memory is the function of ego. The new may be disturbing and it may not be digestible. The new brings some trouble as well. You will have to shift and reshift yourself. You have to readjust yourself. That seems arduous. The ego is continuously afraid of death because it is arbitrary. Hence, there is constant fear. Ego does not arise out of being. It cannot arise out of being because being is life. And how can life be afraid of death? Life knows nothing of death. It arises out of arbitrary, the artificial, and somehow put together the poles, the pseudo, and yet it is such letting go, just that death that makes a man alive. To die in ego is to be born to be into God. The new is not only the message, instant messenger from God as well. It is a gospel. Listen to the new, move with the new, and moving with the new always makes you afraid. In spite of the fear, go with the new, and your life will become richer.